the information within this chapter is gonna blow your minds.
It's your boy Young Goose, I back at it again.
Yeah.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this with a couple friends.
Yeah, it's your boy Young Goose.
Yo, what is up, guys?
It's your boy
Young Goose.
And I'm back again for another
video.
Listen, y'all.
And this video is about chapter 1066. And the chapter is titled The Will of O'Hara. So within the chapter, we get back to where we were at from the last chapter, from 1065. We are with the Shaka Vegapunk, and he's talking about the Void Century at this point in time. As we know, last chapter, he said that this isn't technology of the future, it's the technology of the past. And he told the Straw Hats about a theory that the Vegapunks have of this city that they're in actually being one that was in the past during the Void Century. So as he's talking about, he's saying that the Will of O'Hara is still alive. And yes, it was destroyed, but he went there after it was burned down and he found the books. And one thing that he told us was that Saul was still alive. The giant that saved Robin's life, that Aokiji froze, was not actually killed. I believe Aokiji did this because he was friends with Saul and he wanted the government to believe that he killed everybody on that island, but he didn't kill his one friend. He froze him so that when the fire on O'Hara was unleashed, that he would just get thawed out. Basically, he just needed to warm up, right? So right now we know that Saul is in hiding, but we do not know where. Vegapunk says that it's an undisclosed location, and that is just crazy to me, honestly, because for a long time, Robin thought that she was the last survivor. But in fact, there were two, her and Saul. So when Saul was thawed out and Vegapunk went to go visit this country, he met with Saul and he learned about what happened in the Void Century. What happened 800 years ago in the past, because O'Hara was so close to unearthing this secret, and the government did not want them to show it to the world, as we all know, because knowledge is power. Knowledge is taboo in the One Piece world. So Vegapunk tells the Straw Hats, like, if you know this knowledge, the world government is gonna hunt you down, they're gonna want to kill you, which is why Robin has been on the run for so long, as we all know. Usopp's freaking out. He's telling him, I don't want to hear it, we don't know anything, we're good. But in actuality, it's a good thing that they're knowing this and that they're learning this, because it is the truth. The truth. It's not false like the government wants everybody to think. It is the truth. O'Hara wasn't going to spread lies. They were going to spread the truth, and that was dangerous for the world government. So now we get a flashback of the original Vegapunk with Dragon. And this man looks wacky. Like, he has a large head. Like, you could watch IMAX movies on
his head.
Like, come on now. That's besides the point, right? So as we're having this flashback, he's talking to Dragon. Dragon says, I will make an army that can fight it, that can fight the world government, because that was an unreasonable opinion. In the name of justice, they beat up those powerless researchers with violence just because they had an opinion that was not based on theirs, right? And Vegapunk's like, you, who despises violence? And Dragon says, just see it, Vegapunk. I will change the world. So this is kind of crazy, because think about it. Dr. Vegapunk created the pacifistas, right? A pacifist is somebody that doesn't like violence, that refrains from violence. Could this be the reason why the pacifistas were made? Because Dragon doesn't like violence. Is that why they were named that? Someone that doesn't like violence is not going to commit violence, which is, I think, why Dragon ran away from Blackbeard when he could have just went up against him. Right? Because he doesn't want violence. He's not a violent person. He's not someone that's gonna fight you just to fight you. He'll think of something that's different, probably, right? He's probably a strategist and a fighter at the same time. He's probably strong, but he doesn't like to use violence as the means. That's probably his last means if something is to go wrong, right? So Dragon is having a little dialogue. He's saying, I won't let Clover's death and the Will of O'Hara go in vain. And then Shaka says, the year Dragon, along with Emporio Ivankov and Bartholomew Kuma, they established the Revolutionary Army that shocked the world. So now we just learned that the Revolutionary Army's founders were these three individuals. Doesn't that sound kind of similar? The Cross Guild is doing the same exact thing. Three individuals creating it. But now we get back to present time. And everybody's saying they went to Usopp's saying they went to Elbaf. Nami's saying Luffy's father's very passionate. Robin says Dragon was Professor Clover's acquaintance. I never knew that. And as we know, she spent 2 years with him during the time skip. Frankie says, I'm shocked. Why did Kuma save us? Vegapunk, why did you remodel him? So everybody's just having questions. And Sanji asks, so that bastard Eva is one of the Revolutionary Army's founders, and he's just kind of speechless at that, you know? And so Vegapunk's talking about being in Elbaf, because as we know, Saul was a giant, right? So I'm pretty sure Saul is at Elbaf, and I hope we get to see him again at Elbaf, because that'll just be epic, and it'll be awesome, in my opinion, for the reunion of Robin and her friend, Jaguar D. Saul. And so Vegapunk, Shaka is telling this crew, like, I was very interested in them, and I secretly went to Elbaf. They let me read all the documents. In other words, I've read all about Ohara and the secrets of the world. It's all inside of my head for progressing my research. And she said, the name of the giant's captain is Saul, right? That's what Robin said. And he says, right. And Vegapunk is doing that little epic, anime trope. He's just posing. He's like, yep, I'm an ally for every scholar. That's me. And now we are with Luffy, Jinbei, Bonnie, and Chopper Dono, right? And they're trying to figure out what the thing is. They're calling out, they realize that there's nowhere for them to ride it, and it's automatically moves by itself, right? And so they're calling out, move robot. They want the robot to move. And then out pops the original Vegapunk. The original Vegapunk says, please help me. It failed. He's talking about his warping device. So while he was in a warping, the space got distorted, and this is why he came out looking odd. Odd as in half his body was stuck, right? And Luffy pulls him out. We don't know if he's using like his awakening with that, but like he looks like he stretched his arm out, he pulled him out. And as we know, he knows Dragon, he knows Bonnie from their past. And he says to Luffy, you're Dragon's son, right? I knew you would come here. He says, welcome. He looks at Bonnie, he's like, you're all grown up. And then as we see in the panel, Vegapunk is floating. It's not just by like a power of some sort. The boots are actually able to float. And I'm wondering if these boots are able to float just because of like they want it to be like the moon, right? Or if they're creating this so individuals don't have to have devil fruit powers just to fly around for better means of transportation. But it's also pretty cool because think about it, Judge Vinsmoke, Sanji's father, was working on the same type of technology, and that's what their Germa suits have, right? A flotation device. But this one seems to act differently. It's as if they could fly up around. It's kind of like the Iron Man suit in a way. I think the Germa 66's suits, they have the boosters on the back of their boots, not the bottom like these ones. So it's pretty cool in my opinion. All right, and I also forgot to talk about when Vegapunk initially went to Ohara, right? This was 22 years ago in the past, months after the Buster Call, and we learned that there were ruins on Ohara that Vegapunk found, and he says, it's the giants? Yoshi, pull it out. Why are the giants here? What do they do? Do they know the value of those books? Then we see Dragon saying, it's been a while, Vegapunk. I could recognize you by looking at that standout hair of yours. But I think he just means that he got a big head. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, because he even says, like, did your head get bigger? And he's like, nah. So, as we know, they're both acquaintances of Dr. Clover. And Vegapunk says, I knew him when he was a rough guy who traveled around the world. To label him as someone who tried to destroy the world is unbelievable. That must be some information manipulation. So Dragon asks Vegapunk, are you interested in those giants? I just checked with them earlier. They're not bandits. They came from Elbaf. They knew the value of those books. Their captain's a strange guy with bandages covering his body, which means that was Jaguar D. Saul. The bandages wrapped around his body. He must have contacted his giant counterparts to go over there and grab those books because he knew that they would come of use someday. And that also means that when we get to Elbeth, Nico Robin will see all those books that she grew up around, and she will be reading them to her heart's content. Most possibly, they will mass produce these books so the whole world can know about it, right? So Dragon, at this point, Dragon says that Vegapunk was working with the world government, and he says that he is even a government lapdog, which catches him off guard himself, right? He says, I'm tired of hearing it. Even though we, the Liberation, have invited you and you rejected it. And so at this time, we learned that he didn't want to join the world the Revolutionary Army, but he wanted to join the world government. Then Vegapunk says, don't be ridiculous. Even with my wisdom and technology, what can your poor army make? So you're still a blunt guy as usual, Dragon says. And he says, the world government is a massive organization, especially the Navy. There's a lot of people who can understand me. Don't lose your objective, Dragon. I know, but this incident pisses me off, Dragon says. So, as we know, when Lilith first met the Straw Hat, she was talking about money. She said she needs money to do her projects, her experiments, her inventions, etc., right? So Vegapunk would have joined the Revolutionary Army if they had the funding that he needed to make this Egghead Island and to progress his inventions, which is awesome to think about, because we know now that he is a good guy. When we meet him with Luffy, he's a good guy. Some of the Vegapunk satellites are good guys, right? Like, we see some aggressive ones like Lilith and Atlas, but overall, I believe that they're good. So this chapter was very, very interesting to me. Nonetheless, I honestly didn't think that we would get this much information about, one, O'Hara, two, about the Void Century, three, about Vegapunk, and I didn't think we would actually see the original Vegapunk. I honestly thought he was dead. I was gonna make a theory about the robot that he was experimenting on at the bottom of the, where Luffy and Jinbei, Bonnie, and Chopper were. I was gonna make a theory about that being the original Vegapunk, but that's not true. So my theory was already proven wrong. I didn't even make the video. But overall, this new Vegapunk character, the original Vegapunk, I can't wait to see his dynamic with the whole crew. Hopefully we get to see Dragon come to the Egghead Island, or even to Elbaf, just because we are in the endgame. And I want to see Dragon meet Luffy. I want to see their dynamic with one another, or even if they're the same as Garp and Luffy together, right? But listen, I like the chapter. Let me know if you guys like the chapter as well. I give it a 9 out of 10 overall. Not 10 out of 10 like the last chapter, but 9 out of 10, just because I like action in the chapters, but also I love the information that we receive. So that's why I give it a 9 out of 10. There was no action, but there was a lot of information that we were dying to know. Who was the original Vegapunk? Was Dragon the original creator of the Revolutionary? Who created it with him, right? Where did all the information of Elbaf go? Is Robin the only survivor? No. Now we know that Saul also survived. And now we know that Aokiji is not as evil as we might have thought after he did that, right? Because we thought he was a good, okay guy because he let Robin go, but he froze the friend that he knew. So I honestly think this is an amazing chapter, in my opinion. And I can't wait till chapter 1067, because that's just going to get us one step further to the information that we need to know. And that's probably going to... Honestly, I think that after this island, we're going to Elbaf just because of what we're learning now. Okay, so let me know what you guys think. If you guys think we're going to Elbaf next, say so in the comments. I appreciate you all for watching the video. I thank you all for watching the video. Thank you for getting me the 41 subscribers. Listen, the sky is the limit. And I appreciate you all, okay? Now, it's your boy, 𪷲𪚘𝚙𝚢𝚛𝚒𝚐𝚑𝚝. If you like the video, like the video. If you want to let me know what you think in the comments, say so in the comments and just do that. You know what I'm saying? Don't forget to share the video. And don't forget to subscribe. It is free and you will be helping a brother out. You know what I'm talking about. Now, you all have a blessed day. The sky is the limit. And don't let the clouds get in your way. I'll see y'all next time. And I'm gone. All these years said that I'm even hella cool, 'cause I'm all broken.
so weird.